isn't love till you give it away. When you're 16, going on 17, waiting for life to start, somebody kind who touches your mind will suddenly touch your heart. When that happens, after it happens, nothing is quite the same.
John, can I just have to ask you a question? We're doing a documentary. Julian, what's wrong? The window's down and it's messing up your hair. Julian, why are you such a weirdo? Why is that such a big deal for you? J-Man, what's up, J-Man? J-Man, we're here live Tuesday, May something or other, 16th, 15th. J-Man, bro, what's the over-under on the Bills getting in the playoffs next year, bro? J-Man, bro, why are you not, bro?
Well, we did fire Doug Whaley, which is a step in the right direction.
You feeling good about that, bro?
I still think we're going to fall short.
Yeah, me too.
Maybe a wild card spot.
You looking for a wild card? What about secondary, J-Man? We want some improvements in the secondary? Yeah! Go Bills!
See, now you can't even see me.
Can hear you, though.
Not if I don't make any noise.
Julian, whose birthday is it today? Who is it?
Julian. We're doing some work for the National Archives.
Alright.
On children growing up. We're looking for people that have birthdays today. Do you know anybody that has a birthday today? And importantly, we're seeking out folks that are turning 15 today.
I know people turned 15 a while ago.
Do you know anybody that's turning 15 today, May 31st?
Not May 31st, no.
Does it blow your mind that you're 15 today?
I'm 15.
Traveling to Michigan, and brown hair. From Pappy to Grandma. I'm from picking dry skin and eating dry cereal. I'm from no fires in the house and feeding the dogs. And these are the days. I'm from an island far off in the distance. I'm from Buffalo and Italy, Scotland and pasta. From my one special grandpa, one that's not mine, put the clay model of my dead dog on the top of my dresser to pictures of shells from Florida Beach.
Wow, that was great, Julian.
Hey, Julian.
You will not send this to
Kate. Why are you latched to my leg?
You will not
Julian,
send this.
Do you ever get notes from girls?
It's not working. The force isn't working.
Julian.
Are you sure you're not a weak-minded?
Can I ask you a question? We're doing an interview. We're doing a documentary on people that are dating somebody, but then get notes from other girls that like them.
Can I give Julian a hug really quick?
Oh, no.
Julian, come here. Oh, okay. That's good. Oh, I didn't want to burn myself. You're so hot. I need to put my mitts on.
You okay? Are they burnt?
I'm sure.
There are. Look.
Oh, my gosh.
She's got a hole right in it.
Julian.
I guarantee this is going to be, like, in my wedding video, isn't it?
Yeah, like, and he was in the car going,
why is the flash on? Is he actually videotaping or is he just shining light in my face?
Excuse me, sir.
You're asking if he's videotaping. Welcome to my entire
We're doing an interview.
It hurts so bad.
Would you like to participate in a documentary about the true life of America's teenagers?
No.
We're looking for somebody that feels like they do too much work around the house.
What?
We're looking for somebody that has team member responsibilities.
What's that? I don't think I have too much work to do around the house. I think Noah doesn't have enough work to do around the house.
Oh, really?
Oh, really.
Uh-huh.
Example.
No. I want you to hear how you're saying it. Germans fought in the Danish War. What two regions did they win?
Schleswig and Holstein.
No, you say it like this. Schleswig and Holstein! Go ahead.
Got it.
Try it again. The Germans fought in the Danish War. What two regions did they win?
Schleswig and Holstein.
Schleswig and Holstein!
Okay, sorry, one more time.
Try again. The Germans fought in the Danish War. What two regions did they win?
Schleswig and Holstein.
No, you fell. Joanne, can I ask you a question?
It's really, it's hard.
Getting your weights on?
Can we go to her Shamrock Shakes after this?
Joanne.
No.
Can you say...
I cannot, no.
Welcome to Krusty Burger. May I take your order?
I don't think it's physically possible.
Excuse me, Joanne.
Mm-hmm.
Can I ask you a couple questions?
Yeah.
Did you just recently have a very serious concussion?
I actually do have a headache right now.
Did you get re-diagnosed with a serious concussion? A bruising of the brain?
They said it's swollen. It's swollen.
Swollen? Swollen
like the
brain.
Actual brain.
And, like, do you have some impaired memory?
Sort of, I guess.
Can't remember stuff?
Yeah. But this is all written down.
No, I'm glad you're doing your homework. I just have a question about this. Is a Justin Bieber book. Do you see it? And Julian, can I just ask you a question? I know you're supposed to be recovering. And I don't know.
Can I get rid of that?
Do you or do you not remember being an avid Justin Bieber fan?
I don't think that ever happened.
It kind of looked the same. Can you describe how you felt about Justin Bieber back in the day?
Wait, I know I always disliked him.
Just put his
him.
Face next to your face.
Absolutely not.
You did not always dislike him.
Yeah.
I have didn't. Other video evidence.
No.
Join. It's your Justin Bieber book. Can we get rid of it?
Poison me.
Mm.
It's not my fault.
I saved you for morning rides to school. Join. We're doing a documentary about kids getting their haircuts.
Can you just take a picture? Can you not?
And we're wondering if you want to go to Cutie Pie's Kids Hair Salon.
Here you go. Oh, Axocytosis is in it. That's what I said.
That sounds dirty.
So, see how if there's a molecule that's too big to fit through the transport proteins,
mm-hmm.
it moves and then breaks off, so the membrane, like,
mm-hmm.
like a vacuole.
Yep.
This is like the storage chain that's surrounded by the membrane.
Sean.
Whoops, yes.
Where's the poetry?
So then...
Wait. Can you explain what the metaphor is?
It's a textbook selected
but
Buffalo Public
Schools.
They
have
poetry
in it?
Do you think it's going to have a poet? Okay, so... Once the membrane is surrounding
mm.
the molecule inside the cell,
mm.
it breaks apart, releases the molecule into the cytoplasm,
Sweet.
And returns to the membrane. The
mm-hmm.
phospholipids break apart.
Where's the like conflict?
And then the exocytosis is the same thing. So if it lets in bad things,
mm.
membrane will like slowly form like that, go out, and then release it.
So it's about like how some people in society are like insiders and some
no.
people are like outsiders?
No, it's about cells and how they get molecules in and out.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god. I like it.
We're doing a documentary on movies that people have seen recently.
Can I get the wrong bag of meat?
What's the worst movie you've ever seen in your entire life?
Dirty Dancing.
Dirty Dancing, the seminal...
We just had this conversation so many times.
What? What's wrong with it?
Everything.
For example.
every line from Join. Every scene.
Nobody puts baby in the corner. Some people are wondering why have the peanut butter jelly out along with the panini machine. And we're doing a called Teenagers Cook. We got a show called Teenagers Cook. And we're wondering, would you be willing to share this new sandwich invention of yours?
Nothing
is quite the same. Huh? Somehow I know. Do you feel like old? Sir, the show, I guess I don't know if you've seen cooking shows before, but the chef usually talks about what they're doing, how much to put in, what type of ingredients and where to get them sometimes. Freshness, perhaps a low cut shirt.
Julian, do you still Snapchat when you're 16? What kinds of things do you think 16-year-olds do?
This is the first silent cooking show, I think. Well, actually, that could be our... that could be our angle. Like, you just don't say... Julian, don't say anything. I'm going to ask you a bunch of questions. Do not respond. Okay, that's perfect.
Julian, can we go back to the topic at hand?
Oh, just...
I was listening to some Ringo Starr. So today's a big day. 16 years old. We finally coaxed you out of the womb 16 years ago. You were 2 weeks late, which is sort of perfect. Something, do you have like brownies or cupcakes to bring to school today?
Oh, dude.
So, what do we got going on here? Okay, so what'd you just do there? And is it customary to leave the griddle on so it starts the house on fire? Or
Join. You gonna get your wisdom teeth?
Yeah, I think I'm gonna come in.
What other kinds of things
you need
happen?
To focus on driving?
So, is the idea you eat the sandwich while the kitchen burns down? Okay. So, you use the high shelf to plate it.
Yeah, keep looking at the sandwich.
Okay.
Alright.
I'm gonna go back and film the fire.
You gonna get on, you getting some Snapchats this morning? Some birthday Snapchats?
No, I don't
Snapchats?
Snapchat anymore.
You gotta keep your streaks up?
I hired someone to keep my streaks
DMZs.
Up.
Do some
DMZs? I'm hitting $3 a week.
Did you get some birthday DMZs?
Jolene's starting the kitchen on fire. I don't know if this thing can film heat. Jolene, I'll shut it off for you.
So one of the questions that we have this morning for 16-year-olds, what is your earliest memory? How far back can you... Do you remember your second birthday?
No.
Do you like to eat bok bok? Yeah. Who's your best friend?
Come on this side. Okay.
No.
Who's your best friend?
And here. Gretchen, take a picture of you.
Lola, right there.
Here.
What does a car do?
Come back here. Here. Girl. Bring that along.
Join. So you're saying you remember being three? That's pretty impressive.
I remember.
That was 13 years ago.
Rolling at our house, playing the guitar like this.
Mm-hmm.
Straight up. I remember that elephant slide.
Oh.
I remember getting the elephant slide and we were staying at our Grand Mary's house.
It was the garbage picker?
I think the people next door were selling it.
Oh, right. Good memory.
And then I remember there were donuts that day. I remember going in the garage and walking up the stairs. That's it.
Grandma Mary's?
Uh-huh. I remember Prometheus sticking his nose underneath the, what's it called? You know what I'm talking about?
Mm-hmm.
The dishwasher.
Oh.
I remember going on the, I remember making the fort where I pulled a silverware drawer out and then put the chairs up against it.
Oh yeah. That's a lot of memories to have. Maybe you should. Maybe this is a good point in your life to start your memoir.
I just started my autobiography.
Join.
Parking lot.
Don't you feel like it's amazing to think that you've been alive 16 years? You survived and thrived. And now here you are with your hat and your long sleeve shirt. Hairy legs. Did you shave this morning in honor of your 16th birthday?
Yeah, we will not let you go. Let me go. We'll not let you go. Let me go. No, 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 no. Oh, mamma mia, mamma mia, mamma mia, mamma mia, let me go. Beelzebub has the devil brought aside for me, for me.
To Jakai's dad, why you can't message Jakai?
Yeah, because you have my phone.
Why do I have your phone?
Why do you have my phone? Because I used it for 3 seconds.
Wait.
Yeah.
What?
That's exactly what happened.
You used it for 3 seconds.
I was on it for less than 5 minutes and you took it.
What were you doing on it?
Me?
Yeah.
I was having conversations.
You were violating the screen free policy
I was not.
In 2016.
There's no screen.
2016, Jolene.
2016 just started.
You are 15. Later today, 5:30. Jolene.
Yes.
Do you think it's crazy? You were just a little bobblehead sitting at the table telling stories.
Yeah, 10 years
and
ago.
Now you're just the bobblehead taking the world's longest showers.
Can we not do this today?
Do you feel 15?
No.
The world wants to know.
Why isn't this just a normal conversation you can have?
We're documenting it for the National Archive. Washington, D.C. This will be here when the aliens come and they'll find out about life.
Oh, great.
For 15-year-olds. Julian, 15?
This is not a normal life.
That's like my contemporary period. I remember being 15. I wasn't as cool as you, of course, but...
You have a green light.
Okay. I can multitask, thank you.
No, you can't.
Yes.
You clearly can.
Jolene, what do you want for your birthday dinner? Oh, low battery. Okay, we're back. Do you have any chilling. Listen. Have a super fantastic, awesome day. Bye, Julian. I love you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday, Julian. Hey, Julian, prepare to lead and innovate. Something.
I still don't want to be here.
And then we're really mad about it, but then when they actually did it, they realized that it wasn't really that bad. Can we ask you a couple of questions?
I still don't want to be here.
I know, but can I ask you a couple questions for our research?
It depends on the questions.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how mad were you about coming to the beach with me today?
pretty mad.
10 being you've never been more mad in your entire life at me, and 1 being like you love me and you think I'm great.
At one point, it was not no longer about going to the beach and more about your intensifying arrogance.
What do you mean by that?
I mean that sometimes your arrogance makes you think that you're better and smarter and, well, absolutely hilarious. That's all the time.
Well.
This is a perfect example of it, actually. You've been doing this for God knows how long, and you still think it's the funniest thing that you've ever done in your entire life.
Why are you smiling?
Because I'm glad I'm finally getting these points across to you. Although you think they're, you probably think they're just hilarious. And
well, let's review.
Just a pubescent mind.
I'm 47 years old.
Spewing hormones.
I have a PhD. How are you going to compete against those two things?
You can get a PhD and still be self-obsessed. It's not that difficult.
Wait, I thought it was arrogant.
Obviously. You have achieved both.
What do you mean?
You know exactly what I mean.